Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and today Apple released iOS 12.1.3 to the public. This has been in beta for four different betas and is finally out. Now, this release came in at 2.74 gigabytes if you were on the beta, and it could be a little bit less depending on what device you're on. As you can see, here's my iPad Pro, and it came in at 327.6 megabytes. So depending on your device and what version you're on will vary as far as that goes. Now, before we take a look at the build number, if you're on the beta and you want to get this update, what you need to do is delete the beta profile that's found under General. Scroll down, you'll see the profile here. Once you go into Profile, delete that profile and then either check for an update. If you're not seeing it, then reboot and check for an update and you should have this update. This update, let's take a look at the build number. You can see the build number is 16D40, and this is a newer build number as compared to the beta. So this is a newer version. There is not a whole lot of changes with this one, but before we talk about what's new, let's take a look at the storage before and after. So I took a screenshot of the storage before. I was using 43 gigabytes prior to this, and system was using 16.64. And this storage will vary depending on what iPhone it is and what it's doing in the background. So let's take a look at storage now. We'll go back to General and then iPhone storage. And now we're using 45.7 gigabytes or 45.9. You see it just went up there, and that's probably because it's doing things in the background. And just keep in mind, when you install a new update like this, it may be a little bit slow. In fact, this was a little bit sluggish at first, but we are using less system storage right now. Now, again, this could change in the future, but right now we're using 10.94 gigabytes, so that's pretty good. Now, let's talk about what's actually new in this particular update. So the first thing is there is nothing as far as mentioning any issues with Wi-Fi or LTE being fixed. So Apple has not acknowledged this. However, in the previous beta, people did notice the modem number changed under the system. Down in here, there's a modem number, and that modem changed. And some people are saying LTE is better, although Apple doesn't acknowledge it or acknowledge an issue with LTE, Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, any of those issues in this update. Just keep that in mind. The next thing, though, they did fix is an issue in iMessage that could impact scrolling through photos in the detail view. So they should have fixed that along with the share sheet. So let me go into iMessage. Now I'm in photos in iMessage, and scrolling seems to be working in the detailed view. And also keep in mind that before, or at least for me, this button wasn't even working in the previous beta. So they've fixed that and it seems to be working okay. And photos is working well now as far as scrolling in iMessage. Now, the other thing is they fixed an issue that could cause audio distortion when using external audio on an iPad Pro. Now, this is only specific to the 2018 iPad Pros. So if you have a 2018 iPad Pro and you were using a third-party device through USB or external audio input devices, that should be fixed. Also, if you're using CarPlay and you are having issues on the iPhone XR, XS, or XS Max, that's now fixed as far as some of the issues they were having with it disconnecting. So it's only specific to the newer phones. Now, one thing they didn't mention that I thought was interesting is in the Health app. Let me see if I can find it here. So it's actually under Extras. So in the Health app, when you're using VoiceOver in the ECG under your heart or your health data, some of the VoiceOver wasn't working here with your actual health and heart data. So if you were trying to get it to read back to you, it wouldn't work. Now, they addressed this in a previous beta, but they never mentioned it with this update. So I'm not sure if that's actually fixed. Hopefully it is, and they just didn't mention it in this particular update, but it was mentioned in some of the notes on previous versions. Now, as far as fixes, that's pretty much it, except for HomePod. They mentioned two different things. So let me go into the HomePod. We'll go to settings. So if you didn't know how to do that, what you want to do is go into your home app, and then we'll go back 3D touch, or just hold on your actual HomePod, hit settings, and you'll see there's an update for 12.1.3. There's two issues that it fixes. One is an issue that could cause HomePod to restart, and another one addresses an issue that could cause Siri to stop listening on the HomePod and not work properly. They haven't mentioned anything about sound quality or any of those things being fixed. Now, as far as battery life on the betas, and you saw maybe that just stuttered a little bit, but battery life on the betas has actually been pretty good. In fact, it's been better than the previous version of iOS for many people. In many of the polls and the follow-ups I've done, people have said it's been great. You'll see my battery health is at 100% on my XS Max, and my actual battery life over the past 10 days, you'll see I switch phones a lot, but over the past 10 days, 3 hours, 53 minutes, 49 screen off time. But that's after having 60% battery life at the end of the day. So I could probably get about 8 hours of screen on time if I used it all day long. And that's something that I think is really good with this update. It's been holding out really well as far as battery. Now, as far as this public release goes and battery life, that takes a few days to know for sure. You cannot tell in the first day. There's just no way without using the battery and cycling it a couple times to see what the battery life is actually like with real world use. Now let's take a look at the speed. Now speed on all of these devices is nice and fast. You'll see scrolling across all of them. This is a 6S Plus, my 10S, my 5S, we'll take a look at that in a moment, 10R and 8 Plus. All of the newer phones are going to be fast, but one of the tests I've done over and over has to do with Minecraft, and while I don't play this a lot, one of the tests is just opening it and seeing how long it takes to create a world. And the reason I do that is we can compare this from the previous versions to this one. And if it's fast and not taking a lot of time, then it's doing pretty good. And this one's loading fast for a 5S. So we'll wait for it for just a moment here. So the game is loading, we'll hit play, create new world. Create. So things are moving pretty quickly. Obviously, you're not going to get the best performance on the oldest devices, but it is moving along pretty quickly. Now, if you don't want to watch this part, just skip to the next. I'm going to do a Geek Bench update, and that should be pretty good as well. In fact, let's set this down. We'll let this load in the background as it is taking quite a while to load. Let's take a look at the Geek Bench scores while we wait for that. So let's go into Geek Bench. We'll go to bookmarks here, or benchmarks, and you'll see I got 4,807 and 11,025 for the multi-core score. And that's pretty good, especially since I just installed this and then ran the test. A lot of the times there's background information going on and things being rearranged in the operating system to sort of optimize everything, and it takes a while. Now you can see Minecraft finished loading. Let me set this aside, and then we'll look at the Geekbench again, but you can see looks to be pretty fast. Things are moving along, but that did take quite a while to load. So if you play a lot of games on your 5S, you may have a little bit longer wait, it seems, as compared to previous versions. Now, if we go to the history, you can see the history here. It's pretty good. The single core. Now, this one here I ran on the 15th after the beta had been out for a while and everything was processed. So when I ran it just after the beta 4 came out, it was way lower at 4,817 and 10,951 as compared to today. So it's doing pretty good and it should be nice and fast. And that just gives us a general idea of its improvements. And that is pretty much it for this particular update. There's not a whole lot of features. There's not a whole lot new. And you can expect maybe 12.2 tomorrow in beta form. It's hard to say, but we won't see any real major features until June, usually with the Worldwide Developer Conference, when it's usually in the first couple weeks of June, where they show a new version of iOS, where we expect a major redesign. So there's nothing really exciting going on yet, maybe something with 12.2, or maybe they'll do 12.1.4. It's really hard to say. But if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description below. And also be sure to check back for the follow-up if you're interested. I always do a poll on the YouTube community tab to see how it's going for you. And if you're skeptical about installing it, it gives you a better idea of what's going on with the update. So if you want to check back, be sure to do that. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe and like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.